So you've just discovered the kettlebell. You're looking for some exercises on YouTube and Instagram, and you found one. And you're like, okay, I gotta push, I gotta pull. You stand up, but you're not sure, you gotta check again. Okay, that's how I'm supposed to do it because, you know, I'm a beginner. I don't know what to do, so let's check it out. Okay, first of all, you gotta do a deadlift, or you gotta pull the kettlebell. So what does that even mean? Okay, lift it up. Then you gotta bring it on chest level, rotate it around your head, and you feel your shoulder crackling, and it hurts because you got a shoulder injury. It's been a long time since the last time you've moved some weight, and now it's overhead, but you're not sure. It feels strange, but now you got to break dance around the kettlebell, okay? It's one leg left and the other one right, and but you're not sure. Is this how I'm supposed to do it? Is this what kettlebell training looks like? Really? Gregory from Lebestock here. Guys, I'm gonna show you 10 of the most useless kettlebell exercises you can do when you're starting out, especially for beginners. There's a plethora of exercises on YouTube and Instagram, and I'm gonna show you which ones to avoid and which ones to do instead. Let's dive right into it. The first exercise is the so-called halo, where you rotate the kettlebell around your head. The reason why I don't recommend it is if you have a shoulder injury, this can be really tricky, especially if you haven't been moving weight for a long time. An external rotation is always tricky and dangerous when you use a little bit of heavier weight. So what to do instead? If you want to get a strong shoulder and work your rotator cuff muscles, do some cleans instead, where you let the kettlebell drop into the backswing, pull it up, rest the elbow on your hip, and it's a way better exercise, and it's one of the staples of kettlebell training. The next exercise that is completely useless with a kettlebell is a kettlebell curl. This exercise is best done with dumbbells, so why use a kettlebell when it's best done with dumbbells? And the second thing that you have to ask yourself is, when you are a beginner, is if you want big biceps and you're a bodybuilder, that's okay. But if you want to use your whole body and get the most bang for your buck, use exercises that use more of your body parts. So in this case, we're doing the clean, the exercise that you've seen before. It works your arms as well, even though the focus is in your midsection and your glutes and your hamstrings. And the second exercise, which can be done as a grinding lift, is a row. You work your back and your arms, and you get the most bang for your buck. This exercise is in the same genre like the one we've seen before, the curl. Why do a kettlebell triceps extension when it's best done with a dumbbell? And unless you want to isolate your triceps and you're a bodybuilder, then you're not going to want to do this exercise. When you're a beginner, like we've mentioned before, most beginners want the most bang for their buck. The other question that you have to ask yourself is, once you get your arms in this external rotation position, it's always a little bit tricky for shoulders that are a bit susceptible to injury. So here you see me do a strict press. If I do a strict press and I do a full extension of the arm and the overhead top fixation, I'm working my triceps as well as my lats, my chest, and my shoulders. Now this next exercise, I have to do a little intro for it. A lot of coaches are gonna wanna burn me for this one. And you probably be thinking, but wait a minute, this is one of the basic exercises of the kettlebell. Yes, it is. Is it one of the most useless? No, it's not. But I have to use a tricky title because I believe if I wouldn't have used the title most useless, I think most of you, or some of you, wouldn't have checked out this video. Got you right there. Coaches, don't get mad. The double-handed swing is a basic exercise, but I believe it is useless to some degree because if you keep the kettlebell like this with both hands, you don't have a proper arm-body connection. But if you do a so-called hand-to-hand swing, as you can see me demonstrate right here, you get a proper and awesome arm-body connection. If you get this arm-body connection right, you can relax your arms and you can target the muscles that have to work the most, and these are your glutes and your hamstrings. And it's the midsection that has to do the work and not your arms. And as you can see, I keep my hips extended until the kettlebell reconnects with my body, and this is where I get the most or the best feeling for the kettlebell swing. Now this exercise, or this variation of the swing, has been debated many times. It's a so-called American swing or the CrossFit swing, where you bring the kettlebell overhead. Now, I don't see as much as a problem with the shoulder, even though there might be one. I see the problem with the arm-body connection, the same thing. And if you bring the kettlebell that high up in the air and you don't have a proper grip and you pull the hips back instinctively, because if the kettlebell falls from that high altitude, you instinctively pull your hips back, you don't get this arm-body connection or that awesome feeling where the hamstrings and glutes are working, as you can see right here with the hand-to-hand swing, where I lift the kettlebell a little bit higher. Now, what I'm gonna show you as well is a so-called swing pull. Now, you can see me do it from the front. The awesome thing about it is you can still work a little bit more of your back, you can pull the kettlebell, you can bring it higher, but you don't get this unnecessary torque in your wrist, because you always have to use a back grip, you pull it up, and then the kettlebell falls automatically, so you don't fight the kettlebell, and you still have a little bit more activation of your body. And of course, the final alternative would be a snatch, where you bring the kettlebell overhead, one of the staples of kettlebell training. And this is what I would do if you want to bring the kettlebell in an overhead top fixation. That's what's up. Now, I'm an 80s kid. I grew up in the 80s and I did some breakdancing. I know Mr. Wiggles, I know the electric boogie, I know the kickworm, I know the windmill, I know the head spin, but I don't know what breakdance has to do with kettlebell training. The kettlebell is just sitting there looking at you like, what are you doing? Lift me up and do something with it. This exercise is breakdancing around the kettlebell. It's very popular on Instagram, but I don't see the value. I don't see it. Do some breakdancing, go into a class, but leave the kettlebell alone. What you can do instead is do a goblet squat or any other exercise where you use the kettlebell properly. And since you probably want to work your legs a little bit with this down rock breakdance move, do a goblet squat. You're better off with this exercise. Now, this exercise, I've even seen some athletes do. Jump squats with weight, with a kettlebell, with a dumbbell, it doesn't matter. I believe jump squats, where you put a lot of torque on your knees, I would not recommend using any weight. If you want to do jump squats, I do a small lift. It's about 5 centimeters off the floor without weight. Don't damage your joints and use additional weights. If you want to do jump squats, do them with body weight only. Again, my fellow coaches, don't burn me for this one. From experience, I can tell you that lateral lunges are incredibly tricky and hard to learn. But the reason why I don't recommend it is most people are totally tight in their hips, especially inner thighs, because they sit all day long. So if you're very tight in your inner thighs, you're not able to do lateral lunges. Instead, do reverse lunges. They're way better. They build good muscle with your legs and they help you stand up. They're more functional. And that's the reason why I would avoid lateral lunges. And just a quick one that I want to add to these lateral lunges is, first, make sure that your hips are getting loose. Loosen those hips up with a little stretching, with a little mobility, and always make sure you check your anthropometrics. Maybe your legs or your hips are not made for certain exercises, which is totally fine. But first, if you ever want to tackle a so-called lateral lunge, make sure that you loosen up your hips first. Now, I've already done a video reacting to Joe Rogan's incredible, probably dangerous routine. I don't recommend this exercise because it's dangerous for your shoulders, especially if you use heavier weight. Check out Joe Rogan's shoulders, how they always externally rotate. You damage your joints 100%. So like I mentioned in the Joe Rogan video, I would recommend doing double cleans with both kettlebells at the same time, because your shoulders will always stay internally rotated and protecting your shoulder joint. And this is one of the staples of kettlebell training as well, especially if you want to go into a long cycle where you're going into an overhead top fixation or into the press. And this is one of the best exercises you can do with two kettlebells. I've recently seen this one on YouTube, where a coach is somehow stretching his chest with additional weight and then rotating the shoulder. I believe this is incredibly dangerous. As well, you have to imagine and ask the question. Most of us, we have an office or desk job. We work like this. So the chest is already pretty tight. So if you use additional weight to open up your chest, it's very dangerous. Instead, do a stretch with the weight of your arm only, with body weight. As you can see, this opens up my chest pretty neat and nicely, so I don't have to use any weight. I can just rotate my arm and let the weight of my arm stretch my chest. Now let me preface this one with a little experience. We do individual coaching. We have a lot of experience in personal training as well as small group personal training where we have about 6 people. Now, I can tell you one thing. When I introduce the exercises, especially in the small group setting, we always show 3 exercises in the first session. I used to do 4, but I realized that people are not able to memorize these 4 exercises, especially if they have different rep ranges. We've brought it down to 3 exercises and 10 reps each so that people don't have to think too much, because if they have to think too much, they cannot memorize the exercises. And we always see it happening that even people who are experienced sometimes don't know what these exercises are about because there's such a humongous selection. So just keep this in mind. We're not that good in memorizing different exercises, even the advanced ones. So what do you think? What is a beginner going to do if he sees something like this? Okay, this is the exercise, a deadlift, a row, a clean, a press, a reverse lunge with both legs. Now we go into the windmill, now rack, now clean, snatch, now clean and press, boom. Now straight press, reverse lunge right, reverse lunge the other side, and now going down into a Turkish get up, sliding down, bring it back up, and now it's not a Turkish get up, it's a Turkish squat up. Boom, bang, bam, that's it. Now it's your turn. 1 rep. Now you do it. The reason why I bring this up is I see so many coaches on Instagram and YouTube as well doing incredibly complicated complexes. What is a complex? A complex is actually a cool thing where you combine a few exercises together to make 1. However, it is very tricky to use them in your own workout because you won't be able to remember it, and probably if you're a beginner you do something wrong and then you mess it all up and then you don't like kettlebell training at all. So what I would recommend is split those exercises up. Don't do too much, work with time, and just do 1 or 2 exercises that you're fond of, that you're really working on your technique, because so many people think that they always need a huge selection of exercises so they don't get tired of always doing the same thing. However, if you do the Russian, the Grudovoy sport, the kettlebell sport training style, the awesome thing about it is that it is so subtle. There's so much nuances to the lifts that you will get better over time and you will feel it, and the kettlebell feels better. Everything feels better and it takes time. So if you do an exercise, use the law of exercise. Keep doing the same thing over and over again so that it is stored in your cerebellum and that you can do it automated, and then you can build on it. So that's what I would like to share with all these complicated exercises. Just do 1 and you're good to go. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video helps. If it did, make sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, share it with your friends. And if you want to take a deeper dive into kettlebell training, you can check out our 30 days of kettlebells workout course. The link is in the description. I'll see you on the next one. Peace out.